Is golf bad for my back? The answer is yes. If you're a hardcore golfer, you probably don't care. You might even be angry that I said this. Welcome to a conversation I've had hundreds of times during my career. Despite the science, I can't get my golfers to admit the golf swing is the cause of back pain. Despite the risk of getting more spinal surgery, I can't get my golfers to stop or modify their golf play. Frankly, Tiger Woods winning the 2019 Masters after having a lumbar spinal fusion was a miracle event. While I also rooted for Tiger and I was awed by his win, I knew it'd be a major disconnect from the advice I would give my golfing patients. The golf swing is the most unnatural of activities. There are no work requirements that mimic its effect on the spine. While many believe that golf is a low physical demand activity, the forces experienced by the spine, including the twisting, the compression of the disc, and the side bending, is significant. The downswing happens in less than a second. That is a lot of torque and energy experienced by the spine. Even in a healthy spine without any abnormalities, these are significant forces. In reality, very few people have what is considered a normal spine. We know that because by the time you're in your 20s, more than 20% of the population already has abnormal findings identified on tests. By the 40s, it's greater than 50% of the population. Well, what about you golfers? The demographics of golfing is that of a more mature population. That means it's highly likely that the spine of the average golfer already has some wear and tear. Look at the animation of the golf swing and the impact on the spine. We know there are significant forces experienced by the discs, ligaments, muscles, and joints. In our more mature golfers, these parts of the spine are already worn out. They can be susceptible to injury during the swing. In my prior video about tennis and back pain, we described a transfer of energy from the ground to the ball. The golf swing does have some similarities to the tennis swing. There's also transfer of force from the ground to the ball. The transfer of force during the downswing generates more power when the body is able to smoothly transition. If there are restrictions secondary to wear and tear of one part of the body, it puts additional strains on the other components. The rotation and twist can cause excessive stress on the facet joints, which can lead to localized back pain. The asymmetry of pressure on the disc can cause transient narrowing of the neural foramen, which can cause the pinched nerve sensation. Twisting can cause unwinding of the annular fibers, weakening the disc. The pressure on the disc can cause a new disc herniation. So what does a golfer do? Frankly, I'm not saying you should quit, as I'd rather you stay active. Like tennis, golf is a social sport, and the engagement with others is also a very healthy benefit. I do recommend the following. Take lessons. A bad swing only causes more stress to the spine. Consider putting away the driver. Big swings, more force, more potential to cause injury. Hit from the shorter tees. Better to accept a few jokes from the young bucks than have a severe sciatic attack. Take a drop when in the rough. One more stroke is better than a severe backache. Make sure to warm up your muscles with a brisk walk before stretching. Work on core exercises, including planks. Consider yoga, Pilates, or Tai Chi. Light weightlifting can increase your muscle mass and provide protection during your over-aggressive swings. To my golfers, accept that the swing can cause some pain, then take the steps to minimize the chance of a back injury. Enjoy your game, stay healthy, and stay active. Thanks for watching.